David. David, when the time came for him to be anointed, he was not among the people that were chosen among the sons of Jesse. David was busy in the field taking care of his flocks or his father's flocks. Remember, the Bible says that we are the flocks and the Lord is our shepherd. So that means that David started his ministry in the field where God had sent him. He was already a pastor ministering to the sheep that belongs to God. But according to his own daddy, when the time came for the anointing or for God to anoint one of his sons, David was not even among those that were in his mind. Until the time that the Lord used Samuel to ask whether are these the only sons that you have? And the man said, no, I have one more that is in the field. He's busy taking care of the flocks. He was busy preaching. He was busy taking care of the people that God has entrusted in his hands. And the Bible says that Samuel asked him to call for him because they wouldn't have stayed for a whole day waiting for him to come back in the evening. So he was sent for. And the time that he came, the Bible says that the Lord spoke to Samuel and said, he is the one anointed. Could be the brothers were asking, how come he could be anointed? He's the youngest of all of us here. We are qualified. Remember when Samuel saw Eliab, the first one, he thought that he's the one, but the Lord rebuked him. He said, don't look at the people of this world. Look, because the Lord looks at the heart. For your anointing to come, your heart must be in accordance to the will of God. David did not know what he carried until the time came for his manifestation. Until the time came that he was among the chosen ones, among the brothers that his father was having. He didn't know that. He was just obedient. Where his father sent him and whatever he was told to do, he was doing it. But he didn't know that the Lord was watching him. The Bible is teaching us tonight that we should be obedient to the things of God. Whatever has been assigned for your life, you're supposed to be keen upon it. I promise myself and I say, as long as God has called me, I will never fail to be in the house of God, no matter the challenge. I promise myself that whatever assignment that is given to me, I will do it, whether I'm alone or with people. I will continuously do the will of God because he is the one that knows what he has entrusted in my hands. Hallelujah. David did not know the power he carries until the time came for him to prove himself when the time of Goliath came to be. The topic of the word of God tonight is those that know their God shall do exploits. Those that know their God shall do exploits. That is the book of Daniel 11 verse 32. That is where that main scripture is stated. That those that know their God shall do exploits. David was a man that was taking care of his father's sheep in the field. That means he was already in the ministry. He was a shepherd. That means he was a man of God. He was a pastor. He was so keen with every flock that he tended. Remember, when the time, nobody knew the testimony that David carried until his father Jesse sent him to go and look for his brothers or see how his brothers were doing in the Saul's camp. They were there as warriors. They were there as the army. So the father, Jesse, sent David to go and look on how their brothers were doing. And until he went to where they were, and he found that there was a big man there, Mr. Goliath, that was defying the name of the Lord. And when he was inquiring, the Bible says that for 40 days, this man was coming and defying the name of the Lord. He was demanding and saying, let there be just one man to come and fight me. Remember, David was not even around that area. But because it was time for God to manifest his power in his life, it was time for God to prove that which he has been doing for him at the place of his assignment. The Bible says that when David was sent by the Father, he went. And when he went to the camp, he found where the Philistine were on one side, and there was that Goliath that was standing in the middle, and on the other side we had the children of Israel. But the Bible says that they were afraid because nobody could beat this man, because it is stated that he had been fighting from the time he was born. He was young. Goliath was a big man. He started fighting from the time he was born. So nobody was aware that they can do fight on this man. Nobody was even trying to attempt to do the fight on this man. But I give God glory because of David. So when it is time for God to manifest what he has input in your life, he will send you to that place. Because David was sent by his father, go and look upon your brothers, go and see how they are doing, and bring back the report. As he was going ready to go and see the brothers, give them the food that was given to them, and later come back home and tell the father they are doing fine, or some of them, whatever could have happened to them. But as he arrived there, it was time for God to prove himself in his life. It was time for God to show that which he has been doing in the field, in his place of assignment, it was time to manifest in another level. Hallelujah. Amen. And the Bible says that when he went, he was inquiring, who is this man? Why is he defying the name of the Lord? Why is no one going to fight this man? Who is he? And the people were telling him, this is Goliath, and he has been coming here for 40 days and nights to defy the name of the Lord. And tonight, the Bible says that when David heard that, he was interested. He wanted to go and help. Why? Why was he interested to help? Because in the field, he has fought lions and bears. That none of them, he never lost any of his flocks. That means that he was committed to the people he was serving. And he was only known by the people he was preaching to. The sheep that she was taking care of, those are the only ones that could tell how good David was. Remember, the testimony was tied in one place, but the testimony was in the mouth of David. He knew what God has used him to do. He knew what God has done for him. He knew what God can do through him. And this was the time that he remembered how God had helped him in the field. He remembered how God has delivered the flocks out of the mouth of a lion. Why can he not deliver me from the hands of God? Remember, the children of Israel at that time, they knew God, just like the way we know God. We know what God can do, but there are limitations that are tying us down to not to allow God to be manifested in our life. There are limitations that are moving around us, prevailing us to prove the God that we serve. The Bible says that when he spoke and he was inquiring, who is this man? Where is he from? Why is he defying the name of the Lord? He was planning in his mind on what to do. And the Bible says that there was a reward that was supposed to be given out by Saul upon the man that would decide to kill this man. And the Bible says that David chose to go and seek him Saul. Because he was telling the people around that, I can kill this man. He was giving them the assurance that I'll deal with the man if only he can be given chance. And the Bible says that when they took him to Saul, he was given a chance. But before he was given a chance, Saul was looking at this man as a small boy. And he was telling me, come on, you small boy, how can you fight a man that have lived all his life fighting? And God and David was explaining himself. He was telling Saul, the testimony of how God had delivered him and the sheep and the flock that God has entrusted in his hand from the hands of a bear and from the hands of lion. What is the testimony that you are holding in your life? What is it that you know that God has done for you? That you need to prove yourself somewhere else? That you need to express what God has done in your life to other people? The children of Israel, they knew God. They feared God. But there is this man in their life that they could not fight. There is this man in their life that is tormenting them. There is this man in their life that is pulling them away from God. There is this man in their life that is defying the name of the Lord, and yet there is nothing they can do. We reach in a certain place in our life where the power of God is already in us, but we don't have the grace to do that which God wants us to do. But tonight the Lord wants us to be like David. He wanted to testify and say what God has used you to do, to prove God in the lives of people that know God and yet they have not known the power that is in the power of God, that is in the word of God. The Bible says that when he spoke to Saul, Saul was afraid because he was a small boy. How could you go and fight a big man that has been in the army for a long time? But he said of his testimony, he spoke of what God has used him for. He told people what God has been doing in his life, in his place of assignment, a testimony that no one else knew. Why? Because he was committed to the place of his assignment. How committed are you to the things of God? How committed are you to the things that God has entrusted in your hands? How committed are you to the area where God has called you to serve? How committed are you to the place of prayer? Remember, when David was fighting the devil and the bear, the reason why he was able to see is because he committed the flocks that were given to him through prayer. When you pray, God reveals to you the plans of the enemy. Because if he never prayed, he wouldn't have known that the devil was coming. He wouldn't have seen the lion. He wouldn't have seen the bear. But he was seeing the bear coming to devour the flock that was given to him by God. But he stood and he fought the devil. You can only fight the enemy through prayer. You can only fight the devil by living right. You can only fight the enemy by studying the word of God. You don't know the power you carry until you start walking right with God. There is power that has been bestowed upon our life. All of us, we have gifts. But until we align our ways with God, we cannot see the manifestation of those gifts. When I was studying this scripture, the Holy Spirit was ministering to me. And he was telling me that in the place of your assignment, that place that you are devoted in, that place that you go and serve me, that is the place I will use to lift you up. You can only be lifted when you are committed to God. Only me can tell what God has done for me. Only me can express what promises that God has given unto me. And these promises that I have, this dream that God has given me, there is a time in my life where God will be proved through it. There is a time in my life where God will use me or will send me to a place where they will go and see how God has been dealing with me. Nobody knew about the sheep in the field. Nobody knew how many lions this man fought. Nobody knew the bears that he has faced until the time came for him to face Goliath. Don't you think that David won many souls to God? When he fought Goliath, that means there was an encouragement in their life. That means that there was a time that came for them to think, what have I been doing in the Christianity field? What have I been doing as a born-again Christian? Why can't I fight the enemy with the things that he has put around me? Why can't I fight the devil by the things he has put around my life? Why am I afraid of the devil? Why God has given me power to overcome him?
Amen.
David encouraged the people around. Those people for 40 days, you can imagine how many days they wasted. Trying to see who will go and who will not go. Trying to see who will go first to attack and who will not attack. Yet, they were giving the devil a chance to prove himself in the lives of the children of Israel. That shall not be our portion in the name of Jesus. How many people have you allowed the enemy to devour by not praying for them? By allowing the enemy to go and fight their lives? How many people have you watched with your eyes? They have backslidden. They have gone astray. Why can't we be like David? The Bible says in the book of Proverbs 27 verse 23 that know the state of your flocks and put your heart into caring for your herds. Know the state of your flocks. That sister that you know and you have not seen for a while. That brother that you know and you have not seen for a while. Don't allow the enemy to devour that person. Take care of the flocks and take it to your heart to caring for the hearts that the Lord has given you. This is the reason why David conquered. This is the reason why David overcame. This is the reason why David was used by God to kill Goliath. Who is the Goliath of our life tonight? What is it that you cannot fight for yourself anymore? What is it that has taken the power of God out of you? The grace to pray, the grace to read the word of God, is already upon our life. We are not going to leave the enemy to take control over our lives. Remember, when David killed Goliath, he became a champion. And the reason why he became a champion And the statement that these people were giving, that David has killed 10,000, why Saul has killed only 1,000? They were trying to mock David, I mean Saul. He has been the leader all along, yet he cannot even go and fight this man. Why David came from wherever he came from, and he came and turned the life of the children of Israel around. The Lord will use you in the place where you don't expect.
Amen.
The Lord will make you to demonstrate his power in places where people know God, but they don't know the power that they carry. Mm. Do not be tired of praying. Do not be tired of reading the word of God. Do not be tired of obeying the assignment that God has given you. But a time will come where God will be proved in your life. God will create a scenario where only Margaret can be used to do that thing. Only Pauline can be used to do that thing. And you will not know, because David didn't know that the father is going to send him to the place to Saul's camp. He didn't know, but he just obeyed and left. But God knew that today you will prove yourself. You will prove that God that you have been serving in the field when no one else will see you. I wonder what happened to the flocks that he was taking care of. Because the Bible says that as he was leaving to go to Saul's camp, he left the flock with another shepherd. But we don't know what happened to them. Because I believe God elevated him to another level. He took him to another place where people knew God, but they didn't know the power that they carried to manifest the power of God in our life. The testimony of your life can change lives. The power that is on you, the Lord is going to take you to a place where you will prove the God you have been serving. Remember the brother, when they saw him in the camp, they were asking him, why are you here? Huh? Have you come again? So that you want to fight or something. They were mocking him because they are used to him like he is just a shepherd. But they don't know that shepherding that he was doing there, God was equipping him for a greater job. He was equipping him for a better thing. And I was thinking and saying, if David was taking care of the flocks, that means the sheep and the goats in the field. How is it that when he came here, he's manifesting the power of God upon people? How is it that he's manifesting the power of God upon people? That means that, remember, the Bible says we are the sheep and the Lord is our shepherd. The Lord is our shepherd. So we are the sheep. That means that he was taking care of the flocks. That means he is having a ministry. He was committed to it. He could not lose any of his member because he was praying for them. He could not lose any of the member because the Lord was revealing the plans the enemy had upon their life. And because God has already equipped him, that's the reason why he took him to a place where go and prove the God you have been serving. Those that know their God, they shall do exploits. When the time came for them to fight with Goliath, remember how Goliath was so confident of what he can do. And when he saw David, he called David a small dog. Why are you sending me? Am I a dog that you send me someone? Whatever he was saying. But because David knew that the God that delivered me from the hands of the lion, the God that delivered me from the hands of bear, will deliver me from your hands tonight. He was able to have the confidence because the Lord has trained him. The Lord has given him the grace to be committed to his ways and to his work, that he may be able to overcome the devil. And when it was time for the fight to come, because the Lord has already equipped David, he knew that it is time for me to do exploit, that the children of Israel may know that even then that God can use you to fight the enemy around the people that are connected unto you. Hallelujah. Let us not allow people to backslide with our eyes. Let us not allow people to go back to their vomit when we can see them. Know the state of your flocks and put your heart into caring for your herds. Be a burden carrier of the people around you. Pray for them, even though they may not know that you are praying for them. Intercede for their families, even though they may not know that you are doing that. But when the time will come for God to be manifested in your life, when the time will come when what you have been doing in the secret will be made manifest in the physical, that's the time you will know the power that God has bestowed upon your life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God knows when he will use you to demonstrate his power in your life. Jesse was just sending his son to the camp to go and see his brothers. But the Lord used David to reveal the power of God in his life. It is until you know God and what he can do in your life for you to do exploits. Remember the scripture said that those that know their God. So it is an assignment of our life to know God. Once you know God, then you will be able to do exploits. Until you know God for you to do exploits. When you know God, not only knowing God by his name, but knowing God on what he can do through you. Knowing God on what he has promised you. Knowing God on every promise that he has kept for you. When you know God, only that time you can be able to do exploits. David knew the God he was serving. He knew how God has delivered him. He knew how God has manifested his power upon his life because he was anointed. We have all been anointed by the power of the Holy Ghost. It is time for us to prove the power that is bestowed upon us from the time we came to know God. Hallelujah. Amen. I want us to arise and to pray. That scripture, because we didn't read, because we all of us know the story of David and Goliath. It's in 1 Samuel 17. 1 Samuel 17, from verse 24 to the end. The reason why David won is because he had a testimony that nobody had it in his life. Because he had a testimony that made sense to the life of Saul to allow him to go and fight Goliath. What is that testimony that you are sitting down on? What is it that God has done in your life that he wants you to manifest his power by speaking out on what God has used you to do? David was confident because God has already anointed him. God has already prayed him. It is when you are in distress, it is when you are alone, that God manifests his power upon your life. But until the chance comes for you to prove the God you have been serving, until the chance comes for you to show what God has done you or has used you to do, then only you can be able to win many souls for him. Do not sit down on your testimony. Do not allow the children of God to fall down when you know that you can help them. Do not fail to pray when people are expecting you to intercede for their lives. Do not wait until the time they fall back to their sins. That is the time you'll be rushing. David never allowed Goliath to win, even though it was time for him to prove the God that he has been serving in the secret. The Goliath of our lives are the issues of life. The things that have been taking away the glory of God. I want you to understand tonight, once you know God, you can do exploits. Once you know God, you can deliver people. Once you know God and the things he has done in your life, you can be able to win many souls to him. I want you to open your mouth and tell God, Father, help me to know you. Help me to know you that I may do exploits for you. Help me to know you that I may prove people that God, you are my Father. Help me to know you that God, you may be exalted in my life. It is until I know you that I can do exploits. Out to the Lord and he shall come and deliver you. It is out of that testimony that David was able to deliver the children of Israel from the hands of Goliath, because he knew that God has delivered him from the hands of the devil. God has delivered him from the hands of the lions and the bears. There is a greater testimony that awaits us when we know the God that we serve. The Lord wants us to express the power that he has given unto us. He wants us to know the light has come and the glory of the Lord has already risen upon us. We have salvation. We have salvation. And through that salvation, there is power to overcome. There is power to overcome every temptation. There is power to overcome everything that is not of God. Talk to God and tell Father, deliver me.
Father.
Deliver me, O God, from the hands of the devil. Deliver me, O God, from the hands of the enemy, that I may be able to overcome in the name of Jesus. I want us to pray for those that are backslidden. Those people that you know, they knew Christ, but today they don't know him. And I want you to pray and ask God can be revealed in you. It is by prayer that God can be manifested in your life. It is by prayer that you can know what God has bestowed upon your life. Because you're referring.
Father, we give you glory. Father, we give you honor. Father, we exalt your name. Father, we proclaim you as you are, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. When your word comes, come to strengthen, O God, strengthen every one of us. Make us the vessels of honor. Help us to be sent to you, O God, but to be returned to us. Father, we give you praise. Father, we give you honor. Adoration to thy name in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for tonight and the word. Father, we ask you to strengthen us like you strengthened David in our place of secret, in our homes where God will seek your face, in our place of service, oh God, in the appointment of life that, Lord, you have given us. Lord, we ask you to strengthen our mind, strengthen our relationship with you, strengthen our salvation, strengthen, oh God, our walk with you. Help us to demonstrate your power in our lives. Those that know their God, they shall do exploits. Their grace to know you, oh God. Their grace to read the word of God. Their grace to pray. Their grace to walk in righteousness. Their grace to love. Their grace to take care of other people, Lord. Let it be upon us in the name of Jesus. Father, we ask you tonight, oh God, anyone that is connected to the place of our manifestation, yes, just like the way Jesse was connected to David to send him to the place where the manifestation of the power of God was to be seen. Father, we ask you tonight in the year 2019 that anyone that will make us to serve God better, anyone that will make us to demonstrate the power of God in our life, anyone that will make us to save many souls from the hands of the devil, Father, we ask you that those people shall locate us in the name of Jesus. Those people shall be connected to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Those people will speak to us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we pray. As God, you encountered the children of Israel through David, so shall our life be. Upon the people we have known, upon the people we have met, God, we pray, Jesus, that many shall be encouraged in the name of Jesus. Amen. The Bible said that David fought the lions and the bears. He never allowed any of his flock to die. Father, we ask you tonight for grace to take care of one another. The grace to check on one another. The grace to intercede for one another. The grace to pray for one another. The grace to help one another, Lord. Let it be upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. Let every fear be casted out. As you did for the children of Israel through David, let every spirit of fear be casted out of our lives in the name of Jesus. Father, release your power. Release your grace. We thank you for this word. Let it transform our lives tonight in the mighty name of Jesus. We give you all the glory and we give you all the honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Give a mighty clap to the Lord. Thank you, Jesus.